It turns out that TCP is not a good fit for congestion control for streaming video or streaming audio. TCP retransmits lost packets, but retransmissions may not always be useful. TCP also slows down its sending rate after packet loss, which may cause starvation at the client. There's also a fair amount of overhead in the protocol. A TCP header of 20 bytes for every packet is large for audio samples, and sending acknowledgments for every other packet may be more feedback than is needed. Instead, one might consider using UDP. UDP does not retransmit lost packets, and it does not automatically adapt the sending rate. It also has a smaller header. Because UDP does not automatically retransmit packets or adjust the sending rate, many things are left to higher layers, potentially the application, such as when to transmit the data, how to encapsulate it, whether to retransmit, and whether to adapt the sending rate or to adapt the quality of the video or audio encoding. So higher layers must solve these problems. In particular, the sending rate still needs to be friendly or fair to other TCP senders which may be sharing the link. There are a variety of video streaming and audio streaming transport protocols that are built on top of UDP that allow senders to figure out when and how to retransmit lost packets and how to adjust sending rates.